Hey there! Ready for the big festival? Working hard? Or maybe you have time to listen to a story or two? The destruction of Romulus was a terrible thing. We lost our home and our loved ones. We lost our soul. The people who survived were scattered and leaderless. Survival was a daily struggle. There were some fights for control before Emperor Sela took over, but I never paid much attention. That Taurus woman was never going to get far. Now Sela and Tarsia are attempting to rebuild the strength of the Romulan Star Empire, but they do so with fear and oppression. Steer clear of them if you can. People like us should just try to stay out of the Tarsia's way. Life is more important than politics or power. There are a lot of Romulans who just wander from planet to planet because there's no place to call home anymore. Lucky to have Vera out. This is a good place. A place to put down roots. Without that, we're just dust, scattered by the winds of fate. Do you want to hear another story? Almost 2,000 years ago, our people were Vulcans. At that time, Vulcan was a world of war, with constant struggles between the tribes. Serac changed that. He taught that peace came through logic. And if you ask me, not all Vulcans get that right. Serac said that people should master their emotions, not eliminate them. But not everyone on Vulcan wanted to give up love, or passion, or even anger. The Vulcans said, these people marched beneath the raptors' wings. Instead of fighting their own people, these Vulcans decided to leave in an event we call the Sundering. They boarded great colony ships and set out into unexplored space, looking for a home where they could live and feel as they wished. Eventually, those who marched beneath the raptors' wings found Romulus and Remus. They created an empire. Although we share a genetic bond with the Vulcans, we are our own people. Never forget that. Want to hear another story?
Yes, that's a good one. Genetically everywhere. Kel shouldn't give you too much trouble. A few bursts from your pistol will take care of that.
Loot it.
fungus growing on it that's similar to the spores we found on some of the colored carapaces. It might explain their behavior, but how are they getting infected in the first place? Also, the flying cowards have never come out of the cavern before. Oh, this is so strange.
Something might be happening. Yeah, something might be happening in the cavern. Check it out.
You're right. The source of the infection could be somewhere inside the cavern. Head over there and see if you can find out what's aggravating the nest. And be careful.
Be careful.